Hello everyone, welcome to Maths 2 week 3 tutorial video. So this is the third video. So in this video we will take an example fx equal to 1 by x square plus 1, and we will try to find this integral fx dx in the interval 0 and 1. So in the last video we have seen the left even sum and right even sum and how they approximate this this integration. Now actually we know the formula of this integration dx by x square plus 1 in the interval 0 and 1. So this will give us tan inverse x, and in 0 and 1, so we will get tan inverse 1 minus tan inverse 0. So this will give us pi by 4. Now if I divide this interval 0, 1 into 3 sub interval, that is my x naught is 0, x 1 is 1 by 3, x 2 is 2 by 3, and x 3 is 1. So if I take this as my sub interval, here this condition is satisfied. So x naught is strictly less than x 1, it's strictly less than x 2, it's strictly less than x 3, which is 1. So del x is 1 by 3 for each sub interval. And if I write the left sum, then it will give me f 0 1 by 3 plus f 1 by 3 1 by 3 and f 2 by 3 1 by 3. So this will give us the left Riemann sum. So I am writing it as left sum. And if you take the right sum, it will give f of 1 by 3 into 1 by 3, f of 2 by 3 into 1 by 3, and f of 1 into 1 by 3. So in the first case you can take 1 by 3 common, and it will give us f 0 plus f 1 by 3 plus f 2 by 3, and you know the function, which is 1 by x square plus 1, so we can calculate this value similarly for the right sum also. Now if we divide this 0, 1 in n intervals, so our delta x will be 1 by n, and our sub interval will be x 0 equal to 0, x 1 equal to 1 by n, x 2 equal to 2 by n, and so on, and which will give us eventually x n equal to 1. So if we take this, and if we take the left sum again, so for n sub interval our left sum will give 1 by n into f 0 plus f 1 by n plus until we get f of n minus 1 by n. So if you calculate this thing and take n tending to infinity, you will get this sum as pi by 4. So I want you to check this thing, and similarly for the right sum you can do the same thing, and you will get the limit as n tends to infinity, and this sum will tend to pi by 4. So now let us try to visualize this thing in GeoGebra. So this is the graph of function 1 by x square plus 1, and we are trying to calculate the area under this curve over this x axis in the interval 0 and 1. So this A will represent the number of sub intervals in which we are dividing this interval 0 and 1. And if we see, and at first we are taking the left sum, and if we see for n equal to for A equal to 3, that is there are 3 sub intervals. So this will be the approximated area, this will give the Riemann sum. So it is something 0.8641 and so on. So as we are increasing the number of sub intervals, we can see that it really approaches to the area under this curve. And as we can see, when the number of sub intervals increasing sufficiently, it will get closer and closer to the area under the curve. So let us see the animation again. So yeah, so at first we are decreasing the number of sub intervals and we can get some error, as you can see. And now if we increase this number of sub interval, we will get closer and closer to the required value. Yeah, so this is for the sub interval. Now if we take the upper sum, and again we can see that so this is the upper sum. Yeah, again if we increase the number of sub intervals, we will get the approximate value of the area under the curve. So here the number of sub intervals decreases, so error increases, and now again the number of sub intervals increases, so error decreases, and we will get an we'll approaches to the actual value of the integration fx dx in the interval 0 and 1. Thank you.